Danica Patrick will make history tomorrow as the first woman ever to start at the front of the pack in the Daytona 500. Patrick says she loves the fact that she's breaking gender barriers.
One of the coolest things is to be able to think that parents and their kids are having that conversation at home about it. And to, you know, I've heard stories about a kid, whether a boy or a girl, saying, but mommy, daddy, that's a girl that's out there racing. And then they can have that conversation to say, you can do anything you want to do, and gender doesn't matter. Your passion is what matters. And that's cool.
But decades before Danica, there was Janet Guthrie, the first woman to race in the Daytona 500 and the Indianapolis 500. I asked Janet how she felt about Danica breaking her record.
Well, it was a 36-year-old record. It was about time it was broken. She has excellent equipment, and in qualifying last weekend, she made the most of it. And the proof of the pudding, of course, will be on Sunday.
Do you feel like you paved the way for her?
Oh, when I first put a car in the field at Indianapolis for the 500-mile race there, and also at the Daytona 500, when I put a car in the field for Indianapolis, it was on the front page of the newspapers, not the sports page, the newspapers in Los Angeles, Detroit, Chicago, and so on and so forth. And that is the kind of effect that Danica will have if she wins the race.
Wow, it seems like, you know, Danica really has a respect of a lot of other drivers and fans, and she will still tell you that it's been, you know, a tough road going, but you, you know, were heckled. Some would say that you might even, you know, you were harassed. What kind of adversity overall did you face, and how did that, I guess, either spur you along, you know, really keep you on track and want to drive even faster?
Well, back then, the guys who drove at the top levels had never had the experience of running against a woman, and they were sure they weren't going to like it, and they weren't shy about making their opinions known. And, you know, mostly I could laugh at it. Sometimes it made me mad. But what really mattered was what happened on the racetrack. As long as I could get my hands on that equipment, I could put everything else out of my mind, and that's what Danica will be doing also.
You even wrote in today's Washington Post that this moment for Danica this weekend at Daytona really does transcend motorsports in your view. And you also said that, you know, quote, for 36 years until last Sunday, I had been the best female qualifier in a cup race with ninth place starts at Talladega and Bristol in my rookie season, end quote. But describe, if you will, kind of the butterflies, the anxieties, the excitement that you felt when you got behind the wheel. And if you feel that what you experienced is much of what Danica will feel tomorrow when she gets behind the wheel.
Well, Talladega and Bristol are two different tracks. Of course, Talladega, much more like Daytona. The drafting was tremendously important. So when I started that race in ninth place at Talladega, ahead of Richard Petty, I might point out, I was mostly concerned about what effect the draft was going to have. As it turned out, another car's drive shaft came through my windshield in the first turn, so I really never got a chance to find out.